Okay, now we will move to the next item, which is imprecision. Traditional grade considers only the sample size accumulated, not only, among others, it considers the sample size accumulated, but in the context of network meta-analysis, sample size makes little sense. We suggest to judge imprecision considering another grade approach, which is the width of the 95% confidence interval, and to judge whether it includes values that lead to different clinical decisions. CINeMA requires you to specify a margin of equivalence, that is, a range of relative treatment effects around the no effect line that do not signify important differences between the interventions. Here is again this forest plot alike presentation of the results from network meta-analysis, all odds ratios for incidence of diabetics for each intervention versus any other. And say we have decided that odds ratios between 0.95 and 1.05 suggest that the interventions are more or less similar, whereas values below 0.95 and above 1.05 are deemed clinically important. Then imprecision is associated with the crossing of one or two of the boundaries of the margin of equivalence. More specifically, if the 95% confidence interval does not cross any of the boundaries, then we suggest that there are no concerns of imprecision. If one boundary is crossed, then there are some concerns. And if both boundaries are crossed, then there are major concerns. So let's go quickly to CINeMA again.
Okay. Let's go to the imprecision domain. Here we are asked to find a clinically important size of effect in the scale of odds ratio. This will be constant throughout our analysis. Let's choose an odds ratio of 1.05 to be consistent with the example that Georgia showed. By clicking set, CINeMA informed us that the effect lower than 0.952 and larger than 1.05 are considered to be clinically important. Within each box, which represents a network estimate, we have the judgment being made, as well as an explanation according to the implemented rule. For instance, for CCP versus placebo, we have that the confidence interval extends into clinically important effects in both directions, so it has been pre-populated as having major concerns. The confidence interval for diuretics versus placebo does not cross clinically important effects, so we have no concerns. And for AC versus ARB, we have that confidence interval extends into clinically important effects in one direction, and therefore the judgment is some concerns. As always, we can manually change the pre-populated judgments.